Hello everyone. Welcome to the Savvy Italian Kitchen. My name is Vanessa, and tonight I hope you follow along as we are making day three of our weekly meal plans. So we're doing one of our meal plan menus live this week, Monday through Friday, so people could follow along and kind of find out what the meal plans are like, how we use the same ingredients for multiple meals to save money, time, and to get a healthy meal on the table with your family every night without relying on fast food and processed food. So tonight on the menu is chicken Dijon. We are making a side of rice that I was going to make with roasted broccoli, but it's very hot here today and I didn't want to put the oven on. So today we'll be making a side of some rice and peas. So we'll saute some peas and onions and butter and a little olive oil, add some rice, and we'll serve that as a side dish. So I'm going to go over the ingredients first. The recipe for the chicken Dijon should be on the website. It was there. I think we took it down because there wasn't a picture, but it will be on the website later today or tomorrow under poultry, and that's savvyitalian.com. You will need about a pound of boneless chicken breast, so it's just cleaned. I cut it into, like bite-sized pieces. I also set aside a couple of additional pieces, as you can see here. This will be used for jambalaya tomorrow night, so just set that aside so you'll have it for tomorrow night. You'll need 1 to 2 tablespoons of olive oil, 2 heaping tablespoons of Dijon mustard, and I just had plain French's. You could use Grey Poupon, the store brand, whatever you have. About 3 tablespoons of white wine or water. If you don't want to use the wine, water is fine. 1 teaspoon of salt, 1 tablespoon of onion and garlic powder, 1 tablespoon of coarse black ground pepper, and 2 tablespoons of minced parsley. So the first thing we're going to do is heat up the frying pan. I'm trying to do it a little bit closer here so you guys can see, so hopefully that'll work out. I'm trying to get the cameras with Instagram and Facebook going so that it works for both of you. So I'm just going to quickly put this little piece of chicken aside here. So just bear with me for 1 second. Sorry, my dishwasher is very noisy. And we're going to heat up the olive oil and we'll start. Oh, we also need, I'm sorry, I almost forgot, a half of a Vidalia onion cut into crescents. So while that's heating up, I will just put this aside and I'll cut it. So we're just going to put half of this. The original recipe does not call for Vidalia onion, but I like it. It gives it a nice flavor. So you can either use it or not. That's totally up to you. So I'm just going to cut up this onion. And I like it in crescents because it'll kind of like be the same size as the chicken. But if you wanted to dice it, that's fine too. Or if you wanted to omit it, that's okay. So let me put this one over here and just peel it. And my pan's heating up nicely. And we'll put the olive oil in there. Now tomorrow night we're making jambalaya and beef quesadilla. So if you're following along, I had asked you to freeze half of the beef from our beef with broccoli the other night. So you'll want to take that out of the crock pot tonight. And then you'll follow the recipe on the website under beef for beef nachos. So it's the same ingredients. You're going to cook the beef in the crock pot. So you can do that during the day tomorrow. Or if you wanted to defrost it, in the microwave tonight and defrost and do it overnight, that's fine. Oh, hi, Lana. How are you? Oh, you're finally catching me live. Oh, thank you. So, Lana, we're making chicken Dijon as our third night of the monthly meal plans. We're just following along this week so you guys can see what it's like and decide if it's something, that you wanted to do. It'll have recipes, grocery lists, and menus. And then if you purchase the monthly meal plans, which are on the website, you'll go into a separate Facebook group, and I'll be on there once a week. And I'll go over the ingredients. So I won't be cooking live every night, but I will go over the ingredients. So I'm glad that you caught me. So right now I'm chopping, slicing a half of a Vidalia onion. If you don't have Vidalia, any onion will do. I usually buy Vidalia onions. I like them. They're a little sweeter. They're not quite as harsh as some of the other onions. So when I can get them, that's what I use. So I have my frying pan heating up and I'm going to add about 2 tablespoons of olive oil. And we'll saute these. So we're just going to put that in there. I'm going to just get the onions right in there. Oh, you can hear the nice sizzle in the pan. And I'm going to add a little seasoning to this. Some onion powder, garlic powder, salt and pepper. I guess it's not a trinity because it's 4 things, but that's what I pretty much, I guess that's my house seasoning. That's what I add to almost anything. to start with, unless I'm cooking Mexican food or something like that. So we'll just add a little garlic powder in there, little onion powder, just a little touch, and some Himalayan salt. Okay, let me just turn this down a hair, and a little black pepper. So what are you guys having for dinner tonight? You guys grilling? It's very hot here, so that's why I changed up the menu a little bit. Instead of roasted broccoli, I had some leftover peas from the other night, so we'll actually use them, I think, in the jambalaya tomorrow night, or maybe not. But I always have frozen peas in the freezer, and I just buy, you know, like a 10-ounce bag, and I take out whatever I need for a recipe, so that's a good staple. Now, one of my dear friends made a wonderful suggestion, and Rowie, if you're watching, thank you. She wants me to do a live one day or evening. I'm going to add a little more olive oil so it doesn't dry out. Going over pantry and refrigerator basics. So you guys let me know. Oh, Joanna's having homemade pizza. That sounds good. So let me know if you guys would be interested in that. If you wanted me to do a live going over staples that I have in my pantry and refrigerator and freezer to get a meal on the table all the time, or at any given time, I should say. Okay. So you can see these are just a little bit translucent right there, just to get a little bit going, and they'll cook further as we put the chicken in there. So I'm just gonna lower this heat. This is typically my burner for my turbo boil. I usually cook on this burner, but I'm trying to cook a little bit closer so you guys can see me. So I just have to really be cautious of the heat. Okay, so here we have the chicken, and I'm just gonna, before it goes in, just put a little salt and pepper on there. And then I'll add a little bit more seasoning. We're just gonna put it in and let it kind of brown on each side. That's gonna take about 2 to 3 minutes. And then we'll add our wine or water, whatever you're using, and Dijon mustard. And we'll just let that continue cooking, uncovered. Okay, so for those of you just coming on, I'm making chicken Dijon, and then we're going to make some rice with peas. So the rice should have been left over from earlier in the week. We used rice for a couple of other things. We'll use it for the jambalaya tomorrow. We'll add some sausage and maybe some shrimp, and then we'll also add in some of the chicken. Ooh, which reminded me. Oh, I did take the chicken aside. So I cooked a big batch of rice on Monday, heated up the kitchen one time, and then I separated it, and we're using it tonight, and we'll use it again tomorrow night. So that's what a lot of these meal plans are like. It's purchasing something when it's on sale, like a big package of chicken or a big roast, and just separating it and kind of being prepared and having it in your freezer or your pantry, and then you can utilize it a couple of different times. Oops, man overboard there, and one that I forgot to cut here. And then just using it for several meals. So if you can buy stuff in bulk, like if you go to one of the big box stores and buy things in bulk, you can use it for several meals, and it'll be different and be for the same meal. So I'm just putting the chicken in here. I'm gonna move the onions aside and kind of put them on top so they don't burn, and I'll let these go for about 2 or 3 minutes on each side. And then we'll add our white wine and Dijon mustard, which is why it's called chicken Dijon. So there we go. Okay, let me put this over here. Now I'm going to heat up my little saucepan with about a tablespoon of butter and just maybe a teaspoon of olive oil. And I had some leftover onions the other night, so we're just gonna saute some onions. We'll add about half a cup of frozen peas. Then we'll add in the rice that I had left over. Now you can use white rice, brown rice, whatever you want. And that'll be our side dish. And then if you want to make a quick toss salad or like a cucumber tomato salad with this, that would be good too. So let me get the butter in here. And again, it's all in the prep work, and you can get dinner on the table pretty quickly. So if I have recipes that I'm doing for the week that require like chopped parsley or onions, I like to chop them up ahead of time and put them in Tupperware, or separate them, or just put it all in one Tupperware and measure out what you need as you need it. And that too saves a lot of time and effort. Because I don't know about you, as much as I like to cook, and I love to cook and bake, during the week, I don't want to be in this kitchen for long. Just cook dinner, clean up. There's so many other things you can do, especially during the nice weather. Go for bike rides or, whatever you want to do. So I'm going to add, this is probably about a half a cup of onions, chopped up onions. And I probably put in about a third of a cup. I didn't use the full half a cup. And a little bit of olive oil. teaspoon of olive oil. I'm going to go ahead and season it with our salt, pepper, onion, and garlic powder. And then I'll turn the chicken over and we'll be ready to cook that for another couple of minutes. And we'll make our sauce. And the mustard and the water or wine just makes its own sauce. It's amazing. This recipe was, I think it originated from my aunt, and my mother used to make it all the time. And this was, they called this like a company dish because it was easy to make, chicken is pretty cost effective, and it makes a nice presentation. So this was our company meal. And my mother worked, you know, once I was older, and she did entertain quite a bit, even during the week. So, you know, this was a meal that she could, you know, get on the table for company during the week without taking up too much time. So let me just get my fork. And oh, you can see the chicken's browning up nicely. Can you guys see that? It smells really good. There's nothing like onions and olive oil. Okay, let me put this back on the heat, and this will be another couple of minutes on this side, and it will come together quickly. Now, all of these meals are for about four people, so if you needed to double it for a larger family, or, you know, you can certainly cut it in half if you're just two, like, you know, like Tony and I, or a lot of times I'll make something for four people, and then I'll just freeze it so we have it, you know, on a night that I don't want to cook, or, you know, whatever. Believe it or not, there are nights that I don't like to cook. So I do that a lot. And that, you know, with that too, as long as you package things properly, like if you have them in a sealed rubber container, if you put saran wrap around it really tight, it, you know, helps to keep it from getting freezer burned. So I do that a lot. And I don't leave meals like that in the freezer more than a couple of weeks or a month. I try to use them right away. So Lana is making, oh, barbecued chicken. That sounds good. Are you doing it on the grill or in the oven? That's always a favorite. Okay, so you can see the onions just, you know, they just cooked down just a little bit. I'm gonna add in the peas, and then we'll add the rice in. Now I might add a little bit of stock because the brown rice tends to dry out when you refrigerate it, so I might add a little bit of stock, but we'll see how that goes. So, and we've been at it not even 15 minutes, and we're probably about 10 minutes out. Once our chicken cooks, we should be good to go. So I'm just gonna turn this up a little bit. And you can just put the peas in here frozen. If you have canned peas, you know, that's fine too. Not a big deal. And another thing, this dish is very good if you wanted to make like the broad egg noodles with a little butter and grated cheese. You can also serve, like we had fettuccine with clams last night, so if you wanted to save some of that fettuccine and cook it up today with a little oil and garlic, that would be perfect. So again, it's just, you know, using what you have on hand and making use of things. Lana said, grill, my daughter makes a great barbecue sauce. Oh, she makes it from scratch. That sounds really good. Wow, good for her. I love when, my daughter loves to cook. My son, you know, he cooks a little bit, of course, but I just love when I see the children cooking. It's great. My nieces and nephews are all pretty good cooks too, so it's fun. But I'm finding with a lot of the younger people, which is the reason why I started with the monthly meal plans, is they, you know, they tend to order out a lot, eat out a lot. Of course, now with everything going on in the country, they're all cooking at home, and I don't think they're fully aware of how to stretch a dollar or, you know, how to get a meal on the table quickly. And buttered noodles. Oh, Hannah, yes, buttered noodles are so good. We actually, my aunt, my father's sister, Auntie Dell, who I talked, she was so dear to me. She was a wonderful cook and baker. She used to make spetzle noodles that her mother-in-law was a fabulous cook and baker, Mrs. Gunther from Germany. And she my aunt showed us how to make spetzle noodles, and we just served them with a little butter, and oh, my son loved them when he was a kid. So that's actually in our Fallen Family Favorites cookbook. So if you have that cookbook, the recipe's in there. So that's a good one. I think I have to put this heat up just a little bit. And hi, honey. Ooh. Honey's home. Oh, honey's soaking wet. He must have been working really hard today. It's humid out there. Okay, so you can see the peas are cooking down nicely and the onions. So I'm going to add in, this is about 3 cups of rice. And then I'm just going to coat that. And if I have to add a little stock, chicken just John, hi, I'm sorry. I kissed my husband, hello, he just came in. We'll add a little stock if needed and put a lid on it, so. Here you go. And I do think it's gonna need a little stock, so just one second, have to go into my well-stocked pantry that does have a lot of stock. Wow, you really had a busy day. You look like you were filling that bag. Okay. And I buy the stock when it's on sale. It could be Progresso, Collagen, you know, the store brand, whatever. So I'm just gonna wing it and probably start out with about half a cup, and we'll just soften up that rice a little bit. And then I'll taste it and see if it needs additional seasoning. So I'm just gonna put the lid on that, if I can find it. Okay, there you go, that works. For once I chose the right lid, I usually pull the wrong one out. So we'll let that steam up. And I'm just gonna turn the chicken once more. Okay. And you just wanna make sure that it's cooked through. So however long it takes, obviously, so it's not pink inside any longer, you know, that's all you need to do. Oh, I love the sizzle sound. Let me get a wooden spoon because I don't wanna. Okay, so you guys can see that. That's cooking up beautifully. Now I'm going to mix, what do we have here? Don't mind Blaze, it's dinner time, as you all know. We're gonna add 3 tablespoons of white wine or water if you don't want to use the wine, and 2 heaping tablespoons of Dijon mustard. So for those of you just coming on, we're making Dijon chicken and a little rice with peas and onions on the side. This is our Wednesday, day 3 of our meal plan for this week. Okay, so let's get, I'm gonna put 3 heaping tablespoons of Dijon mustard, and again, any brand will do. This is French's, this is what my husband came home with last night, that's fine. I've used the store brand, I've used Great Coupon. Okay, oh, that was 2 tablespoons of mustard. See, I'm talking too much. Let me put this aside over here. Okay, and 3 tablespoons of white wine or water. And we're just gonna whisk this together. We'll add it to our chicken and onion mixture. We'll cook it uncovered just until the chicken is cooked through, and that should take another 5 minutes or so. And if you did want to serve a salad, tomato salad or cucumber salad on the side, while this is finishing up and while the rice and peas are cooking, or heating through, I should say, that would give you enough time to prepare the salad, and we'd still be under a half hour, maybe like 20 minutes or so. Okay, so let me just turn this around, and let's spoon this in here. Oops, I'm starting to burn a little bit, but it's getting a nice crust on it, and that's what you want on the outside. So, get our onions out of there. Hold on, guys, we're almost there. Okay, so you can see how that's browning up nicely. Smells really good. Okay, so in goes our liquid. And it should make its own sauce. Now, if I have to add a little bit more, I will. And we're just going to turn this down a little bit. And it really comes together and makes the sauce quickly. You want to scrape up any of the onion bits on the bottom, of course, to get all that good stuff in there. And if it needs a little bit more sauce, I'll do like a tablespoon of wine and a tablespoon of mustard and just add it back in. And then I will show you our peas. And then at the end, we will add some coarse black pepper and parsley before serving. Okay, so let me really lower this. Okay. And we could even add a little pinch of chicken broth just to let this go a little bit further. So I just added maybe about a tablespoon of chicken broth. So we'll let that continue cooking. And here are our rice and peas. So this was leftover rice that we cooked on Monday. You know, when we made, what did we make on Monday? Oh, fried rice. So we cooked extra rice. I had about a half a cup of onions. I used a little bit less, sauteed them in some butter and olive oil, added some frozen peas, and now I'm just gonna check for seasoning, and that'll be our side dish. So this, we can definitely turn off. So I'm just gonna taste that, and then we should be good to go. So don't forget, if you're following along, defrost your 1.5 pounds of meat for For tomorrow night's dinner, go to the website, savvyitalian.com, under beef. Look up, I think it's crock pot beef nachos, and you'll use that recipe to cook the beef in the crock pot for tomorrow night's dinner, which is going to be beef quesadilla. So we're going to make quesadilla. You can put cheese on it and a little jambalaya on the side. Okay, let me just taste this. Well, that's actually really good. And if you wanted to put a little mint in this, my husband's not crazy about mint, you could put some chopped up mint in there. That would be good too. So I think the chicken's good. I'm gonna take it off the heat and let it go. And we'll bring it a little bit closer so you can see it. And that's it. We got this done in under a half hour. I think that was about 20 minutes or so. Okay, so let's get my hot plate out. And I think we're gonna get it in just before the rain again. So hopefully you guys can see that. Okay, get our rice over here. And I'm just gonna sprinkle it with, so it calls for 1 tablespoon of coarse ground pepper. So I'm just gonna wing it and put it in here like this. And then we're gonna hit it with the parsley. About 2 tablespoons of parsley. And, that was a little bit too much. And there you have it. So there's our chicken Dijon, our rice with the little peas and onions, and that's our Wednesday night meal. So again, if you're following along, we'll be on at 6 o'clock tomorrow night, and then Friday I'll be on at 6. We're going to make just chicken Caesar salad. Fridays, you have to cook easy on Friday or order pizza or something. So thank you guys for watching. I hope you have a good rest of the night. If you did, who's that, Rosa? Do you serve the chicken over the rice? Rosa, you can, actually. You can serve the chicken over the rice. That's, salute, thank you. I know, I didn't pour my wine yet, but thank you, I appreciate that. I'm probably gonna have a glass. And if you wanted to check out the meal plans, they're on the website. And that's it. If you have any questions, just inbox me. And as always, I appreciate your messages when you let me know what you've cooked and you send me pictures. It really, really warms my heart. So I do appreciate that. And I'll talk to you guys tomorrow. Have a good evening. Take care. Thanks, Tony. Salute. Bye-bye. And we're almost ready, Instagram, to say goodbye. Okay.